Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahawashai, Bahashem, Raka, Kwadash. Double honors unto the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone. I'm learning this truth. Shalom to all the Aki and pushing the truth in our sincerity and our honesty. So basically, you know, I was, you know, scrolling on the internet and then I came across this article, man, by The Independent. And it reads, Russian state TV claims Putin is more likely to launch nuclear war than accept defeat in Ukraine. Either we lose in Ukraine or the Third World War starts, says top Russian propagandist Margarita Simonyan. Vladimir Putin is more likely to pursue all-out nuclear warfare rather than concede defeat to Ukraine, a top Russian state TV editor has said. See? And this is prophecy of the WW3. It is gonna happen. It is going to happen. Okay? It says... it says Margarita Simonyan, editor of state broadcaster RT, one of Kremlin's highest profile media bosses, made the remarks on TV on Wednesday night, declaring that Mr. Putin unleashing a nuclear strike is more probable than failing its so-called specialist military operation in Ukraine. And that's actually going to happen, right? Even if that never come out of Putin's mouth himself, that's definitely what's in his mind, for real, because this is Bible prophecy. This happening is going to be the ending of this kingdom, ending of modern day Babylon, you know, and its rulership. For he says the remarks added to a pattern of escalating rhetoric on both sides as Russia continues to warn the West of lightning fast consequences over interfering in its ongoing invasion. Yeah, man, because you know, the West, you know, mainly America, you know, NATO, you know, getting involved in Russia's business, you know, which in turn, you know, if Russia ends up, you know, getting defeated, then all our war is going to happen because, you know, other nations has interfered in his business. And really and truly, this is Yahweh Bashimashai's movie is supposed to play out like this. Either we lose in Ukraine, Ms. Simonyan said, or the Third World War starts. I think World War III is more realistic, knowing us, knowing our leader. See, it's right. World War III is realistic. It is going to happen. The most incredible outcome, that all this will end with a nuclear strike, seems more probable to me than the other course of events. This is to my horror on one hand, she told Panel of Express, but on the other hand, it is what it is. We will go to heaven while they will simply croak. We're all going to die someday. You see, you got this woman here, you know, saying that, you know, it is what it is, man, it's going to happen. You know, so it is what it is. So us, you know, that are in this truth, us that believe on Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, we should be in that spirit of it is what it is, because guess what? When it happened, we're going home. You know, we're finally gonna be going home. We're finally not gonna be under this kingdom's rulership, under this kingdom's oppression and all of these things. You know, and basically, that's the point I wanted to make. I don't want to go too much into it. I'll read this. I'll continue reading from... Mr. Putin, while issuing a warning to Western nations... While issuing a warning to Western nations over interfering in the war... referenced Russia's new intercontinental ballistic missile, the Satan. See? Russia's got a new ICBM missile, and they call it the Satan. We have all the tools for this, ones that no one can brag about, and we won't brag. We will use them if needed. And I want everyone to know this, Mr. Putin said. We have already taken all decisions on this. Russia warns it will deploy Satan 2 nuclear missiles capable of hitting UK by autumn. Russia has announced it will deploy its recently... Oh, Slovakia. Russia has announced it will deploy its recently tested Satan 2 missile by autumn as tensions between Moscow and the West mount amid the Ukraine war. You see, so World War 3 is imminent. World War 3 is going to happen. You know, it is what it is. You know, we just pray and hope Yahweh shall have mercy upon us and save us. You know, I'm going to read, I'm going to read some precepts and then close. So I'm going to start with Jeremiah 50. I'm going to get a few verses from here. It says, Jeremiah 50 verse 1, the word that the Lord spake against Babylon and against the land of the Chaldeans by Jeremiah the prophet. Declare he among the nations and publish and set up a standard. Publish and conceal not. Say Babylon is taken, Bel is confounded, Merodach is broken into pieces, her idols are confounded, her images are broken in pieces. This is the main point. For out of the north there cometh up a nation against her, against Babylon. And we know that this nation is talking about, you know, Russia, right? For out of the north there cometh a nation against her. Because, you know, north, you know, it said for out of the north, because north, Russia is north of the land of Israel. Okay? So we know that it's talking about Russia, which make her land desolate, and no one shall dwell therein. They shall remove, they shall depart, both man and beast. I see. Now I'm going to get Jeremiah 51. Start for verse 1. It says, thus saith the Lord, behold, I will raise up against Babylon and against them that dwell in the midst of them that rise up against me a destroying wind. Right? So, you know, Babylon today is modern, is America. But the modern day Babylon today is America. And the destroying wind is talking about nuclear missiles, man. You know, which is going to destroy the earth. You know, we can read that in Revelation 7, verse 1. That destroying wind is talking about the ICBMs, nuclear missiles that Russia has, verses 2, and will send unto Babylon fanners that shall fan her and shall empty her land, for in the day of trouble they shall be against her round about. You know, it says, and will send unto Babylon fanners that shall fan her. You know, and these are the nations that's going to come, you know, and help to fan the flame that's burning America and shall empty her land. You see, and when he said empty her land, because no one's going to be left in the land, it's going to be left desolate, man. You know, it's going to be left desolate, man. When those missiles drop, man, everyone that's dwelling in the land of America is going to be dropped. There shall no one live in that land again. It shall be left ultimately desolate, man. You know, we can go back to Jeremiah 50, but go to verse 13. It says, because of the wrath of the Lord, it shall not be inhabited, but it shall be wholly desolate. Everyone that goeth by Babylon shall be astonished and hiss at her plagues. You see? So what is this talking about, Russia, you know, may start World War 3. This is what the scripture is talking about. This is what the prophecy, you know, of Jeremiah, you know, from in the scriptures, man. I can also get wait 1 second, let me see if there's any more. Oh yeah, verse 3. Verse 3, against him that bendeth, let the archer bend his bow, and against him that lifted himself up in his brindergine, and spare he not her young men, destroy he utterly all her host. See what brindergine armor. Okay, so we know that's war, man. Talking about brindergine armor. Right, verses 4, thus the slain shall fall in the land of the Chaldeans, and they that are thrust through in her streets. You know, the Chaldeans are talking about modern day Babylon, man, America, man. You know, verse 5, for Israel hath not been forsaken, nor Judah of his power of the Lord of hosts, nor though their land was filled with sin against the Holy One of Israel. You know, so obviously, obviously, the nation of Israel, we went off, we done wickedly, but, you know, they're not completely cut off, man, you know. Verse 6, flee out of the midst of Babylon and deliver every man his soul. Be not cut off in her iniquity, for this is the time of the Lord's vengeance. He will render unto her a recompense. When it says flee out of the midst of Babylon, it's speaking about spiritually, man. Come out of this world, come out of the lifestyle of this world, and, you know, seek Yahweh Shimei Oshai, That's the point I wanted to make. I hope it was edifying, you know. I just saw this the article, and I just wanted to do a lesson on it, man. So we see Russia, you know, Putin is talking about World War III and ICBMs, and you know, you'll rather start World War III than lose to Ukraine, and that's exactly what's going to happen. World War III is going to happen, and that's going to be the ultimate time when the rulership in this kingdom is going to come, is going to come to naught, it's going to fall, you know. And you know, Yahusha is going to come during that time, you know, and you know, ultimately destroy this kingdom, save, you know, his chosen, you know, save the elect, save the remnant, you know, and rebuild the nation of Israel, you know. And you know, ultimately we're going to be ruling the earth in righteousness under Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, you know. So with that, I'm going to say all praises to Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, Bashim Rakakwadash. Double honors unto the apostles and elders, I'm learning this truth. Until next time, I'm going to say Shalom.